So everything's welcome back to the Elder Scrolls Daggerfall. I've actually been grinding up my longbeard skill so that I can be eligible for this next promotion in the Knights Guild, in the Knights of the Rose, which is to be a promotion to Seneschal. And for that, even for the next promotion, I'm gonna have to graduate even more. But guess what I got in the quest for this? In the quest to grind up my longsword. Just look at this thing here. This amazing danger build. My god. I never thought these were a thing in the game, but apparently they are, and now that I've found them, it's amazing. It's amazing. Just look at this thing. It gives me plus 10 armor rating. Just for my head, yeah. But still, it's a plus 10 armor rating. What else could I ask for? And, yeah, I mean, I'm almost completely. You know, I've got like tons of Daedric stuff, just this left pauldron has always been an issue, always lagging behind. Because, I mean, even these are adamantium. Could have been ebony, but these are adamantium. The boots, the cuirass is ebony. And, oh yeah, these are mithril too. So, maybe not as close as I initially thought, but two items away is not that bad, according to me anyway. But enough dilly-dallying around, let's go ahead and grab an impress from the sky. Before that, I would rather like to save you. And let's see what you have for me. A rumor has surfaced as to the whereabouts of an ancient artifact of power. This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. Are you up to it, Marshal? Now this is where things get interesting. I have been wondering about these quests. I mean, I completely missed them while playing Arena. I never knew that. You have to ask around about rumors in order to, you know, unlock quests like this. And I thought it was just for roleplaying, you know, something that leads to nothing, but apparently not. But in this game, I suppose this is one of the ways you get access to Daedric, you know, artifacts. Might as well. I thought I detected a gleam of ambition in your eyes, Grimfangs. Supposedly a fish living deep inside the bowels of Sekotrugoth? Is that how you pronounce that? Has discovered a clue about where to find this thing. I'd start with her. Right, so I'm guessing this is going to be a multi-dungeon crawl. Not that I mind that. Yeah, I do have the sword equipped. What was that place called? Sekotrugoth? Right then. In Wayrest. Find Sekotrugoth. Yeah, I can't exactly travel by ship on land, so might as well travel by Orc Shaman. Yeah, okay. The atmosphere immediately changes as soon as you enter a vicinity of the dungeon. So, while leveling up my sword skill, I actually. It literally starts off with this module. I strongly dislike this module, to be honest. But anyway. That is Nock. One that I would love to stay. Yeah, so while leveling up this skill, I actually used up a lot of. I had to read like 3 dungeons. That being said, one of those spells was. One of those dungeons was. How do I put this? Privateer Sword, right. Sorry about that, it's been a few days since I've recorded, so I'm a little rusty at that. But anyway, I can't find this guy who's slinging spells at me. Maybe he's someone up top? Probably an Orc Shaman? Yep, right there. Most likely an Orc Shaman. Now, this would be a good opportunity for me to test out. Oh wait, I did not bring it with me to that. How foolish of me. Hold up. Let me just go ahead and get it from here then. Good thing the intention entrance is so close. Now then, the bow and arrow. I also bought like a Daedric bow and arrow. I think it's Daedric. No, adamantium. Either way, it is good enough to cause serious damage to other books. Also, something that I want to show you guys. This shield It seems to be made of iron. The other shield, that's why it's not as shiny. Now, it's plus 4 to armor, stainless steel, but it's actually 10 kilograms. While this is only 6.5 kilograms, or like 6.25 kilograms. So this is most likely made of steel and hence lighter in color. Now, I did not actually expect this game to have multiple kinds of color, but multiple kinds of armor, so to speak, not color. But oh yeah, completely forgot. I might also need, should probably also equip this, and what's this? Yeah. Long shield of undeniable access. What I find incredibly funny is how it's called the open tunic of friendship. You know, it increases your charisma when you wear it. Sort of. I mean, you guys can understand what I'm getting at here. Why people would like you all of a sudden? Should you choose to wear the shirt? Now, where are you? I think that. Yep. Yep, it was an Orc Shaman. The Orc Shaman has died, and yeah, I can now finally cause damage to these guys. Like, even bigger enemies. The 8 of these, this. Adamantium bow. So, my primary skill long lead is at 80% right now. 80%? How did it travel up and move with it? Granted. Anyhow, that leaves me like with lesser levels to grind it up to for the next promotion in the Lightly Order. But yeah, this kind of dungeon, I don't really particularly like it, primarily because of how convoluted it is. It's also one of the first dungeons that I had ever cleared. One of these modules, not this particular dungeon, but I suppose some of that carries over into why I dislike it so much as well. One good thing about this dungeon, however, is the fact that there are very few hidden doors. If you can simply drop something here to note the fact that I have actually been this way. Of course. And the tension starts being messy right off the bat. These guys appear out of nowhere, and if you don't move out of the way soon enough, they will essentially just wreck you. I don't know what spell they use, whether it's like a shock or a fire spell, but yeah, it's pretty powerful. The first spell is invisibility, of course, but the second spell onwards, it's oh no. Two of my most disliked dungeon modules in one dungeon. Oh no. Yeah, that is a bad room. We don't want to go inside that room. But since we're here, might as well go and explore the side. Should be a scorpion behind him. I saw you because I could hear it. Hi there. Oh, Warlord. Now, typically I would examine their helms, but I also have something that's amazing. So, this seems nice. I think it's elven, if I'm not wrong. Or maybe it's just regular old steel, but it's nice. But yeah, since I have a dwarven helm, I'm not really that eager to. Ah, okay. Yeah, but I think this was another module that I had previously found in yet another dungeon in the same area. I think the previous dungeon that we went to. I think that also had like a similar module. One with successful backstab of Warlord died. Right then. Maybe we'll take this arrows as well, since we sort of spent two pieces on that Shaman there. Now, I actually swung down because that does the most damage, but also has the least chance of it. Thus far, this dungeon appears pretty straightforward, so there's not really seem to be much of a problem in that regard. But I wonder how straightforward it would be once we start heading down. Let me just go ahead and save the area. We'll see, boss. Oh, there's another level up. Interesting. Let's go up first then. Lock has nothing to fear from me until I decide to bash the damn thing open, of course. An orc. Orc warlord. And one of the things that I like about this, about fighting enemies these days is that upon a successful hit, they get knocked back. That sort of protects me from them by not letting them get to me. But yeah, this dungeon module is essentially similar to the one that I've seen before. And I think that was in the Roost of Skullcraft itself. Does it have that? Yep, it does actually have a hole in the middle as well. So let's deep clear of that area. I wonder why none of these enemies can detect my presence. Is my stealth skill that high already? I wonder. I cannot help but wonder. Sometimes the objective that is searching for can be inside this crate here. Saving again. Oh no, but alright, it's fine. You ordered me to save before entering this dungeon and for accepting the quest, so it should be fine. When I typically reserve save slot number 1 for when I'm starting off with a new recording, like, every time I sit to play this game, that's the one that I use. You paralyzed me? Okay. Let's see how long it takes me to wear off, and just look at the quality, or rather the attributes of the armor that I have right now. This guy's barely good with me, but a band can still hit me. Okay, maybe I should use a potion. Yeah, I might as well use a potion with the action right now. Because that was sort of bad. Okay, let's go back up and rest. This should be a good spot, I think. Stealth and dodging have improved and I'm now fortified. There should be another level down that I think leads to an area with water. Yeah, just look at this guy. I mean, that was critted. Now, I think it's also because of the age of my armor, but what I'm noticing is that these days I'm only getting critical hits on me, and I do think it's because, yeah, there's only an underwater area here, so I don't think a witch would be in an underwater area, but then again, I could be wrong. Stone bench that appeared out of nowhere. Typically there are humans in this area as well, but since there aren't, I'll let bygones be bygones. And polygons be polygons. I see an Orc Shaman and I kill an Orc Shaman. Good thing this guy's not good with me. What did I just hear? It sounded like somebody being strangled. Yeah, that thing. What is that thing? Is that what a witch sounds like? I think so. I think it might be a witch or maybe a dangerous loser. I don't know what this is. I have no clue whatsoever. But I... Oh, there's something in there. It should be just an empty... You're gonna make me use another potion reaction, huh? Where's the potion here? Okay. I was about to say, did I just run out of potions of reaction? Because that would suck. Saving there. I think you're close to the witch because I can hear something like the witch. So I can try going in here and seeing whether there's a witch here. I do hope there is a witch there. And it is in fact a witch, not something like a dangerous seducer or something. I don't know what that was. I don't hear her anymore. Which is something that sort of concerns me. So what I'm gonna do right now is, I mean, this is gonna head outside anyway, so I'm gonna follow this route, and if it does not lead me anywhere close to a witch, I hear another orc. Maybe on the other side of this locked door. Just an orc warlord. The guy locked into the water there. Now then. Oh, I think that's what that lever does. It enables me to get over there. Right. But here's the thing. I could hear a witch while I was down there. Something like a witch. But I don't hear her anymore up when I'm up here. Let me just go ahead and invest here. Save the game. In this lock. And let me go back there. Just to check. What exactly it was that was making all those sounds? Oh, Warlord just died. That is good news indeed. Now I do not hear the voices anymore. I do hear the voices right now. That sounds like a witch, to be honest. That does indeed sound like a witch. Could there be a witch somewhere? Was that a date residue? Underwater, maybe? You know what? I'll just see you in the origins of slot. And in case I can't find the damn witch after exploring the rest of the dungeon, I'll come back here. And I'll essentially try to find her. And that is it. This is the entirety of the dungeon module. Nothing else here. Now, typically, this is another one of the places where a quest artifact might be. But unfortunately, unfortunately, the bitch is not here. So, let me try jumping across the step. I do believe I can do it. But in case I cannot. Oh, I could not. I'm just gonna load up the save here. For some reason, I overestimated my ability of jumping. Yeah, let us go ahead and use the potion of levitation. Hopefully, I have those. I've got two: a bracelet of venom antidote and a diamond of venom antidote. And I've got unstrainable taunt. Oh, I completely forgot about those. I don't even need potions of reaction right now. I can literally just use the unrestrainable taunt boots. It's one of the magical items that I got during one of my raids. I don't know whether the raid was shown on camera or whether I found it while I was grinding up my level, but yeah, these are essentially boots of reaction. Pretty much what I've been searching for all this time. Yeah, potion of levitation right here. Yeah, good to know that I also have a potion of reaction just in case that does not work out for me. Hi there. Oh, poor lord. Nice to make your acquaintance. Good to dominate you. Too bad you're not alive. Another orc warlord. I wonder how there's so many orc warlords. That is gonna fetch me a pretty penny, so in case I find something of greater value, might as well drop one of these. Because they won't. Oh, right, I really forgot. I need to gently cover it up. I've got the levitation spell selective. I could hear a witch singing over there, but I can't hear her singing anymore. So, peeking out of this side, okay. So this seems to be a rather short dungeon. Not as long as of a crawl as I thought it would be, from the looks of it. But then again, I think this is going to entail us going to yet another dungeon. So we're going to have to be wary of that. We went right the last time, and I think we took a turn to the right, and that led us to I don't think there were any more turns ahead, were there? Oh, okay. Alright, so that's right. So let's keep heading out this way. Hi there. I hope you had a fun time. Ooh, I like that. I like this thing. Whatever this is. Wait, does it say peasant? Ah, yes, it does say peasant. I'll keep that. I don't know what that is, but I'll keep that. Since there's nothing here, right? Yeah, there's nothing here. Might as well go this way. Since I see this guy, I'm just gonna go with the sleeve, and then I'm gonna go the right way. Which means I'll be turning right. Let me just drop something here. I like how most of these enemies actually drop ingredients that I can drop to the ground. Have some of these stuff. Okay. One hit and it's open. Nothing here. Long winding dungeons indeed. I'm literally one hit and two hitting new enemies in this game right now. Might as well pick this up because there's nothing here. No point in keeping this here. I'll drop it. Maybe I'll drop it. Left to right. Let's go right. Right, it's set. I'm guessing this is a dead end too. Sorry, can't use the gold. Except for while spending it. So, I'll just carry it with me. Yeah. Might as well leave the drop in here. Because that way we know that we want to come here. I see you. I see you. Let's do it. Let me come engage you in mortal combat. Three same strikes. No variation in the strikes whatsoever. And this guy still peels over and dies. Anyway, I want to head here first. Oh, yet another. I think that is the person that I'm looking for. The witch. And she looks pretty. Wow, hi. Oh, okay, okay. I see. I see, you can actually get quests from them. That's interesting. If you ever manage to find them, that is. I think I did find some witches villains during my exploration of the dungeons. They were marked on my map. I just don't remember where the names of the dungeons, actually. I am Vannon Beckford. So, you want Orange Shield. It is true that I know something of it. You must do something for me if you wish to learn my secret. Long ago, when I was younger, your grandfather was less than a believer in your great-grandmother's eye. I gave birth to a daughter. I don't know why she had to put it that way. Your grandfather was less than a believer in your great-grandmother's eye. I left the child to be raised by others, but now that my powers are waning, I need an heir. My daughter is long dead, but I have a great-granddaughter of the right age named Grimin Buckingham. Bring her to me within 7 days and I will tell you what I know of Auriel's shield. Grimin Buckingham's parents know nothing of her birthright and will certainly resist any attempt to take her. He will find her in palace in Tangate. Right, thought as much. So, we can just use a potion of levitation to get down here. No need to jump all the way down, and since we are going to be exiting now, might as well save it here. And jump right down. I mean, we didn't take fall damage, but it's okay. And we didn't even take that much damage, to be honest. My god, you're terrible. I'll essentially do that from the inventory itself. Like, I was thinking of transferring some stuff into the inventory, and I feel like I can just do it from here itself. No need to go all the way there. These things. Should I? What is this again? Then I might as well do it, right? Might as well equip it, since there's an empty slot there. And this thing, I wonder what that is, but I'll just keep it in the wagon for now. So that I remember to. Oh, get it tested later. Wayrest, tap it. Right, on for toss, of course. Let me go ahead and sheath my sword. Now I need to look for the palace. Let me see if there are any announcements here. Whoever is formerly allied to Wayrest. Oh, nice. Is it because I've been going to poetry a lot? I wonder. But then again, the politics of Daggerfall don't really revolve on me. That would be too presumptuous of me. Where's the palace? Should be somewhere over here, actually. Ah, yes, right here. This is what I suppose the palace is. The palace. Might as well go there, unless I am wrong. And the palace is somewhere around the center. Like it was the center. Does not seem to be the case, really. So yeah, up to the very northeastern corner we go, hugging this wall essentially. Alright, let's be on our merry way. Wonder if we're gonna have to fight some human enemies for this. And whether this quest will actually give us any experience points with the Knightly Order, the Knights of the Rose, I mean. Oh, the things I do just to go up in some sort of an imaginary rank. Wait, this does not seem like the palace. In fact, it is not the palace. So where did I go? Huh, interesting. So that is not the palace. That is just a cemetery. I thought it might be just a cemetery. Oh, there it is. Right, the very eastern side of this map. So I need to head southeast. Sorry, west inside of this map. I always get east and west confused. I'm guessing that was the Royal Cemetery all the way over there. I was wondering why there is no structure to that building, but oh well. So I have to go and talk to the woman there. And hopefully they agree to let her come. And this here would be the palace. Small little palace, nothing too large, but oh well, whatever works. I'm hoping there won't be action inside, but just in case. And since palaces are treated as dungeons, might as well. So who am I looking for again? Villain Buckingham. Okay. Let me choose an info mode first. At least there are people here. Ash Silk. Mr. Ash Silk. King Ash Silk. Am I supposed to fight him? Yeah, I guess I am. Intruder! Intruder! Says the guard that is about to be dead. Boy, you are durable, aren't you? Ah, just as I said that. I should probably choose my words a little more carefully. Thing is about these kinds of castles is that I can just access a wagon ride from here. I mean, these aren't exactly treated as dungeons, but like places where you can enter and exit freely. I'm guessing you are the person that I'm looking for. Yes, right there. What are you doing? I don't want to go with you. Help! Mommy, Daddy, help! Oh, there's another one of you guys. Put down Quinn and Buckingham, or I will be forced to kill you. Nah. I'm not gonna put it down. Screw you. Although I feel a little bad doing this, delivering a child unto a certain demise, you're not gonna do anything here. Oh, that's a you problem, I guess. I wanted to find a way to get on my high horse and go back to what was the name of the damn place again? Sekotrugoth. The real gods, the true gods. Right then. Yeah, there's the dungeon entrance. I wonder what then was that sound that I could hear when I was at the base of the place, you know? I'll save it in front of the dungeon entry in case there's some batshit crazy monster in there. Time to use a potion of levitate. Hopefully I have the potions of levitate I need. Ruby of shocking, wand of lightning, please grab our firewalls. Yes, right. Potion of levitation. Why don't you hold up right there and let me come beat the shit out of you? Oh wait, wrong side. Yeah, that's the good side. Should be another one of you guys there. I'll just take care of you and then I'll go ahead and talk to the woman. The witch. I mean, I don't exactly want to beat a witch, but yeah. Talk to her. Ah, yes, my heir. What did you say its name was? Winning Buckingham? Yes, she will do just fine. Did we just kidnap a random child? Grimfangs, you have earned the right to pursue Auriel's shield. The stars have told me that the path to Auriel's shield leads through the Elyria tradition. That's all I know. Now, what do you mean by the Elyria tradition? I guess you can't talk to me anymore. That's fine. We sort of got what you wanted from me anyway. And I wonder if that is like the name of a... No, not really. I'll look it out. I wonder if that's the name for place. Let me just check it up. Path to Auriel's Shield is through the Elyria tradition. Elyria. Right. Let's look that up on Wayrest. Oh, it is a place, okay. I guess I know. The room is sketched in blood something. What is this place? This door, I wonder. Where is the door? Here it is. Got turned around for just a second there. That's the first time I've seen this kind of a... door? Like, entry to a dungeon? Okay, that's some anxious music. That is some really anxious music. An entire cave system, from the looks of it. No wonder the entrance is like that, like an actual damn door. I wonder if I'm gonna meet somebody here who's gonna point me to the right way. Oh, so this was actually a mining colony. I see. I see a knight breed from the looks of it. Battle mage. Hit hard. Hit really hard. Sort of want to rest here. But then again, I know that I cannot. Oh. Okay. I'm just gonna close this door and go back here. But there are hopefully no enemies, and I'm gonna rest. Of course, there are enemies nearby. My god, she took up a huge chunk of my health. I can't rest here either. I guess the only option that I have right now is to trudge onwards. Oh well, let's go for it then. Right. Should we discover that side first? Nah, let's go. Since this is closer to us and everything, I wonder if this also has. Oh, it's the same kind of place down there. Okay, so the dungeon warden is familiar to me. More demon enemies, I wonder if they're battle mages. I hear some disturbing things right now. But, over. Here we go. Time for me to make a save here. In case I die, you know. What? Oh, just a room, nothing more than that. What I like about this module is that there are very few hidden doors. What I dislike about this module, I think that's a day drop. Yes it is. This guy died before we even got a chance to get the DNA. And this is practically what I was talking about when I said that my attacks now knock enemies back. Battle mage died and left behind some heavy damage, my god. I think at this point I should just go ahead and use a potion of heal tool. If I have any. Or maybe a potion of healing should suffice as well. I'm saving here. Should be a way up there. Played that a little more tactically. Was successful to play tactically. Was successful in playing it tactically rather. In fact, that I did not get tagged as much. Wait, where's this one? Where's this person? I'm stuck. Excuse me? Oh, you're a mage. I'm pretty sure you would have hit really hard if I had given you the opportunity to. What is this? Oh, this is a regular old spell. Nothing of significance. The music is really getting on my nerves, to be honest. I'm healed. Good. Save here, let's keep stretching on. Let's... two paths, but this isn't really a path, it's more of a dead end. Good thing that we mapped it out. And this is also dead end, but it has a battle mage here. So, that's that. 299 gold, and ooh, look at this, mithril right baldron. If I already didn't have a Daedric gun, I would have totally taken that. And since the entrance to the dungeon is too far, I might as well carry it. It'll fetch like some pretty gold. Don't think there are any hidden doors here. From the looks of it, there aren't. This was just a hall with enemies. Now, if I do believe I came from down there, and this room should be just a dead end. A resting room of sorts. Might as well take this opportunity to rest. Of course I can't, because there are enemies nearby. So the question now remains, how do I get up there? Am I gonna have to rely on a potion of levitation? Because I was sort of hoping that this would let me get up there without any issues whatsoever. That is one of the areas that I will check out later. Not right now. Oh, I see you shooting. You're shooting arrows at me. Huh? You're shooting arrows at me. Let me go ahead and shoot some of my arrows at you. Let's see how you like them apples. If we can do left and right as well, please. Thank you. Was that you? The guy who hit me? Sorcerer, it was a sorcerer, hitting me with arrows of all things. I mean, if you are such a sorcerer, why can't you just use a spell? This area is full of battle mages and things of that nature. Now, I can use this and cast Slow Falling to fall down there, but from my previous experiences, I know that to be a trap. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to explore the upper area first. Maybe this is a zombie or something. I don't know. Nothing that is holy, anyway. So I don't exactly want to go down there right now. But I will go up, and that's the way that we need to go up. Yeah, might as well. Another potion of levitation for us. Page up to float up. I just wish we could float up sooner, like easier. It wasn't as difficult to float up. I can see two people here, but like two figures there. The rest of the area around this is pretty much the dead end. It doesn't really need anywhere, so let's go right first. Let us drop something here to denote the fact. You seem to be a mage. You tried to do something to me, but I did not succeed in killing you first. Cannot carry a new stuff already. But I mean, I was pretty close to the entrance, I feel like. Might as well have gone back and dropped some of the stuff that I took, but it's alright. I'll just leave this here to denote the fact that we've all been. You were sorcerer. You did not look the part. Why didn't you use any spells? Like, she used no spells at all. Do you notice that? A sorcerer who does not use spells. Oh wait, sorry. Oh, of course, there's nothing here. Once you get an idea of the module, you begin to realize that it's all pretty similar to each other. There's not much variance when it comes to, you know, these dungeon modules. And that is something that I feel like they could have done a better job of with Arena. Sorry, Daggerfall. Not Arena, this is no longer Heaven School's Arena. This is Daggerfall right now. I bet there's somebody at the end of this. No? Okay. I guess I'll just rest here. Daedric. Stealth. Oh, maybe my Daedric got improved when I took down that Daedroth. But the most convoluted mess that I've seen up until this point is that one part, that one place that I went to. I don't even remember where that was, but I had to go there for some sort of quest. And I did that on screen on the record, actually. Okay, there's nothing here. It's official. It was a short trip. But wait, there was the other side that we did not explore. So might as well go ahead and explore it then. We went right, but we did not go left. Oh yeah, we did actually go left, but did we? We did? Oh yeah, we did. We did in fact go left. Right, we went here, but we have not gone here yet. Let's go here and check what's been what. And if there's nothing, you might as well just come out of it altogether. So, once these guys run out of mana, they resort to just throwing hands and bleeds, so that's something. That's a nifty little detail, actually. So there's nothing here either. Find them. Let us head back. And yeah, we just need to jump down and be on a merry way, unless of course we want to check what's down there. There typically isn't much down there, actually. Actually, there's nothing down there, to be honest. But there always could be. It's an ambush area. It's a trap, essentially. So I'm gonna save the user slot and we jump right down. So spell effect failed. I do not know what you guys are up to, but... this guy is just chilling out in the back. I don't know doing what and why that guy's just chilling, but he is. Oh, of course, right. I cannot carry more stuff. There are enemies nearby. Now, here's the thing. If I open this... oh, it's a magically held rock. Okay. Maybe I am at the right place. I hear the sound of something falling. And I don't know why this... side just lit up. I see something back there. I don't know what that is, but there's something fiery back there. I have a strong feeling I need to probably save the game here, but I cannot for the life of me figure out how to. So these are all magically held blocks. I wonder if I can open them at all. Oh, maybe I have to pull on the chain to open them. Let us reload this game, then. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna jump down here first and suffer a little bit of fall damage so that I can pull on this chain. And oh, I'm levitating right now. That's quite good, actually. I'm gonna equip the bow and arrow since that is essentially adamantium. I should be able to take out my foes with great ease. And the same goes for you. Where are you? Underneath me? Okay, wait, hold up. Let me go ahead and re-equip this. Sorry. Equipping katana and tower shield. I've sort of found this habit of calling it a katana, even though it's a katana. Like, the proper way of referring to it is a katana, but I have begun calling it a katana because of Americans, the way the Americans pronounce it. I see something there, and I don't know whether I want to go engage it. Okay, that was a fire spell of some sort. That was a battle mage and a very hard one at that. That was intense. That was intense. Pretty sure there are more people here than there. But, yeah. There are enemies nearby. I should probably put on a few potions here. Slow falling, no resist shock. Might as well. Might as well put on a potion of resist frost. And a potion of healing. Because I feel like this is essentially where the actual game is taking me, and I think that damaged me a little, indicating that it might not be the correct door for us. What is that? Is that a fire daedra? Huh. Killed it just that few bits, huh? Not that impressive, are you? I thought you would be tougher. That damaged me again. So I'm guessing that is not the correct door either. Yet another fire daedra. Successful backstab. Did twice the damage. Saved me a lot of effort and pain. I'm guessing this then is the correct door. Sorry, correct. Switch then? No? This door opens. And I cannot carry more stuff. Elven shortbow, not really interested in that. But I think I should be able to rest here now. Should be one last switch. And this did not damage me, so that is good. Although I'm not sure what this did for me. Certainly it did something. I don't exactly know what it did for me, but it did something. It probably drops me into a world of hurt. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save here first. Oh, it actually takes me up. Okay. takes me a little too high up, but I'll take it. Whatever works, I mean. So I guess we discovered that that area was pretty much pointless as well. Unless the place we have to go is down there in the water. No, it's just an elevator, there's no underwater area there. Only when you stand on it does it actually push you up anywhere. So I guess the way back was over here. Ah, yes, there's the cave. And we are on the other side, so basically the cave's on the other side of this. So nothing here. Now that we've ascertained that, I feel a little better about myself. Albeit a little regretful about wasting a few potions. If I might put it that way. But there are two parts here. Whoa, I did not expect this guy to be here. Now, who's hitting me? Resist poison, okay. Gold pieces, maybe I'll take the gold pieces. I do not exactly need a potion to resist poison. I'm silent, so, but I did not know who was assaulting me. Oh, wait, I can keep the. Oh, that's who was assaulting me. Okay. Yeah. Doesn't really fetch that as much money either. Oh wait, I could take the gold, so that was nice. So what I'll quickly do right now is before I proceed further, I'll just go back near the entrance and I'll who's the entrance up here? I'm fortified, good to know. Yeah, let me go back to the entrance and essentially just keep this in the wagon. Excuse me. And let me just save the game here again. Just for good measure. The soundtrack is really anxious, so that's one thing. It's getting me a little nervous. Making me a bit. What the fuck is that? Is that just. That's an impaled human, it's a dungeon decoration. That thing. Oh my god, that's another impaled human. Talk about the decorations in this game, my god. And. Is there a way up that I should be looking at? Anything here? No? Huh. So I do believe this area in the Rift of Skulls of Fact was grim. This room is grim. No, this area in the Rift of Skulls of Fact was pretty much underwater, from what I recall. I'm remembering bits and pieces of this area, and if I'm not wrong, this leads to. I feel tuned. Really? She tuned me, huh? Cannot carry any more stuff? Why is that? Am I already equipped? Huh, interesting. Probably all the gold that I looted from these people. Because in the end, even though they are enemies, they are still people. Remember that, guys. They are still people. Treat them with the respect they deserve. Which is none to be precise, but still. Battle mage. These guys can fight. I'll give them that. These guys can definitely fight. Probably should have checked out the other side of that area as well. I see a spire danger. I wanted to do the opposite thing, but ended up doing another thing entirely. What do we have here? Oh, an entire... Why did this guy just bounce off me like that? Is he using like some sort of fire spell or something? Like an explosion? Megumi! But no, this is true, probably not Megumi. Enemies nearby, let's go straight, I guess. I mean, we are gonna have to procedurally clear out this entire dungeon anyway, so. You are a sorcerer. I never wonder how that works. Should I just drop this and take the gold instead? Yeah, that makes more sense. just coming here to verify the fact that this is in fact. Dead end. Ooh, my long blade has improved and so is my backstabbing. I think I'm ready for the final level. Medical is 38, intelligence. I wonder why this is highlighted like that, but okay. Running is 92, my god. I'd run a lot total. Yeah, so medical, I need 37 in medical to be eligible for. The rank of Paladin in the Knightly Order and a long lead skill of 87. And at this point, I do believe I have both. Ooh, Fire Daedra. I wonder if this guy's gonna damage more now that. Well, this guy doesn't get a chance to do that, but I wonder if he was going to damage more now that I didn't have a fire buff on him. Is this gonna open? I don't think it does. I mean, these aren't actually doors, they just ripped up. I mean, they used to be doors at one point before they were ripped up. But now that they are ripped up, they don't open anymore. An empty room? Yes, empty indeed. Nothing there. No need for rest, but I would like to see the game here. This is yet another dead end. So now that we've taken a little detour, might as well head back on the critical path. A fire danger for this corpse and burn. I think this is where we came from. This is indeed boss. Okay, so we are going to check that side. So I guess we'll go ahead and check that side. There's also the continuation of the area which I left behind. But I have a feeling we'll get there shortly. Because if this cave system moves the way I think it does. Who the hell was that? Okay, I now understand why people use potions of. Resist fire. Resist shock, resist frost, resist fire. It's right here. Because this guy wrecks you. This guy can absolutely wreck you. Without a second thought whatsoever. Yeah, it essentially leads us down here. So, we'll go this way. Wait, let us go back up and. You know what, I'm gonna clear this area down here first, before I decide to go back up. Yeah, we went right the last time, I wanna go left this time around. I see Daedrops. Makes sense for there to be Daedra in a quest about Daedric artifacts. Even if there are like minor Daedrops like this. And not, you know, full-blown Daedra Lords. Although there are Daedra Lords here as well. Oh wait, we haven't come across any yet. Let's not jinx it. Even though I have a feeling that I might be coming across one soon, sooner or later. Cannot even carry any more stuff. Honestly, no point in checking any further. But I still would like to see. I keep an opportunity, like, be in search for, you know, better gear, essentially. Now, there are two paths here, we can take a left, and I do not know where that goes, actually, or we can continue here. Let us see. First, no matter where we go. And then build set. Let's just keep going here. I think this should be just a room. Oh, it's not. No, it is not a room. Nothing here. Which is a good thing. Nothing here either. Right. Let us trudge onwards. Nice mutations. You would think it not silence me because one of his brethren has already pulled that trick on me. Oh wow, it's an entirely new heat system right here. Should I go down there first? I hear something down there. Might as well try going down there, I suppose. Okay, there are two paths that we choose here. Let's go down this way. And if we're lucky, we'll just come back up to the point, maybe to the fork in the road. I do believe, yes, this is the same place. So we have wanted to come here. Let us, in fact, dig this room up. To further focus in this road, and I think that is a fire dagger. Let us go ahead and use a potion of resist fire. I hope I have enough. Because otherwise, it's going to be a rough ride against these guys. The flames have been extinguished. I like that little touch. The flames go out when these guys die. Also the fact that these guys, the fire on these guys' bodies, they actually light up. Oh my god, so many of them. Hi. I suppose I have the high ground at this point. Ha. Showed you, Miss Boss. So this is where I came from. I can go left as well. I can of course go check what's down here. Oh wait, I've already explored this side. Right, so this is where it comes out. I can also go here. Let's stick to the cave for now. We'll go check out the paved side later. Oh wait, right. So this is essentially the same path around. And I think that's, that holds true for the majority of this dungeon, this cave system module. I wonder why the game is lagging so much. I never thought that a game like Arena would lag. But I stand corrected. Elven broadsword of I don't know what it does. Oh, what am I gonna drop here? How heavy is this? 3.75 kilograms. So we need to drop like 3.775 kilograms of stuff. I wonder what I can drop, to be honest. Can I just drop the horse? Or the wagon? But no, that would be stupid. But that would be a bad decision, to be honest. Huh. I wonder where this is going. Use maybe? Wait. Hold up. When did I get this letter? Interesting. Grimfangs, my good friend Lord Woodbone says, you are a hero that can be trusted. I would be truly indebted to you if you could stop by sometime to chat. Maybe you could even do something for me. I would be oh so grateful. Princess Alice, Castle Wayrest. So, I know what that quest is. And the problem is I'm not going to do that quest right now. Wait a minute, I've got gold? 5 random gold pieces in the inventory, how does that work? I wonder. Maybe I dropped that amount of gold sometime and it just stayed in my inventory. But yeah, anyway. So that was that for this side. Let us go and explore the other side then. But this can also be a location for this boot here. 277 gold pieces, adamantine claymore. Interesting, but unfortunately I cannot pick it up. Or can I? Of course I cannot. Huh. Yeah, this is also one of the areas where a quest item can be spawned. Is that what I'm looking for? Oh my god, okay, this is the shield. Alright. What do I drop now? Okay, this is interesting. Might as well get rid of the arrows, we can always buy them later. What else can I drop them? This and this perhaps. And this. Does that work? Still too much to be able to lift that. Okay. Maybe. Yeah, that's very light, not heavy at all. What can I drop? My god, this is something nice. Maybe I can just entirely drop my shield altogether. My quest is complete. Yes, let's go. Okay. Wait, I do not. Let's equip this. I wonder what this does. Plus 4 to armor rating. Item powers, caster only. Just a caster. Okay. Auriel shield, an ebony shield said to have once belonged to the quasi mythical elvish deity Auriel, can make its wielder nigh invulnerable. In its resistance to fire and magic, Auriel shield is unsurpassed. Like many artifacts of Tamriel, the shield has life and personality of its own, and does not feel bound to its user. A popular fable tells the tale of it abandoning one wielder in the greatest hour of need, but this is perhaps apocryphal. Spells, resist fire, shield, and spell reflection. I see. So, which way do I go in? I mean, I have seen that thing many a times before, but never had I made the connection that was actually Auriel's shield. Never had I actually made that connection. So I guess it's time to head back then, now that we are done exploring all of this. Might as well rest here until we pull the guild. I do hope that it is actually a good shield and I shouldn't just go ahead and use a tower shield instead. I can hear something like an enemy, but I cannot see where it is coming from. But I suppose it does not matter at this point anyway. Time to head back now. I came here for all your shields, I found it, and now I head right back out. I wonder if this actually gets me the reputation with the Mage Guild. If it does not, then I would much rather just go ahead and make this a separate video altogether. Right then. I suppose. Yep, the mission is complete. The mission is absolutely complete. Let's go back to Wayrest then. Yeah, I'll go to Wayrest. My critical strike is improved, apparently. So yeah, the quest that Princess Elisina is summoning me for is essentially going to tank my reputation with Wayrest, and that's going to make it difficult for me to get to the rank of Paladin. So yeah, I need to be careful and approach this cautiously. Hold up a minute. I'm gonna check something. This gives me plus 4 armor rating. And I think. This is the same? Yeah. So this round shield is practically the same as. Auriel shield, like a tower shield. That is nice, that is nice, that is something that I can totally respect. Open tunic, of course. I'll keep this in my bag as well, for it to be identified. But this I'm interested in, long shield of the wise, got some health wisdom. Let me just go ahead and equip this. And equip these. Because I sort of want to increase its longevity, like rather their longevity. And yeah. So we started out on a quest for the quest to essentially rank up in the knightly order. We could not do that, of course, because I don't think this quest actually gives us any XP in the knightly order. But what we did manage to do was find a pretty radical shield. So yeah, I'm quite happy with that actually. Am I on the wrong side or something? No, I'm on the correct side. Let's still try going and talking to the guy and let's see whether it actually has any sway over our reputation with them or something, whether they, he tells us, congratulates us for a job well done or whatever. Am I? Yeah, it's behind us. Huh. I thought the building was closer, apparently it's not. It's difficult navigating this fog. Ah, here it is. Alright. I'll just get off my house here. And I'm gonna just stand around here for... what's the time right now? Yeah, essentially 5 hours. 3 hours at a time. So you won that which you quested for. What would you have now? That's it. So I guess that's that. I mean, we don't really get much for this quest apart from just the shield itself, no reputation. So I suppose that's that for today's video. And when we come back, we will be covering more quests for the knightly order. And hopefully, we'll get promoted to the rank of Seneschal now. So until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow folks.